Tata Motors has done it again, where its newly launched Altroz, the premium hatchback, has secured a global India 5-star rating for adult occupancy and 3-star for child occupancy, and making it the second Indian car after Tata's own Nexon to have global 5-star crash test rating. So on this note, why do you think other car manufacturers are not emphasizing on safety and they are making poorly built cars? Vote by clicking on the R button above and let me know your thoughts by commenting down below. And welcome to the Automotive News episode 57 from Under the Hood. Honda Activa 6G launched today, which as the name suggests is the 6th generation of Honda Activa. The new Activa now gets a fuel-injected BS6 compliant engine. The Activa is now 23mm longer, which results in more floorboard space and more seat length. The company has focused largely on engine this time, which has reduced friction in various moving parts in the engine. Also, the fuel economy of the vehicle has increased by 10%. The new Activa comes in two models, that is Deluxe and Standard, with Standard priced at 63,912 rupees and Deluxe priced at 64,412 rupees ex-showroom Delhi, which is an increase of approximately 8,000 rupees from the 5G model. Honda is also offering 3 years warranty and 3 years extended warranty for the same. The much awaited Bajaj Chetak, the electric scooter by Bajaj, was launched yesterday. The new scooter is available in two variants, which are Urbanite and Premium. The Urbanite is priced at 1 lakhs and it comes with drum brakes, whereas Premium model is priced at 1.15 lakhs and it comes with disc brakes. Just to give you an idea, Chetak has a maintenance interval of 12,000 kilometers of 1 year, whichever comes before, and it has a warranty of 3 years or 50,000 kilometers, whichever comes before. Booking for the Chetak is now open and link to the booking site is in the description down below. Audi has launched its new flagship SUV, the Q8, the price of which starts from 1.33 crores. The Q8 will be brought as completely built unit to India and is limited to 200 units only. If you don't know what a completely built unit is, the car will be brought as a whole as completely assembled model and it won't be assembled in India. Kia has released details of its Indian spec Carnival MPV, which will be available in 3 trims options of 7, 8 and 9 seaters. Powering it will be a 2.2-litre diesel engine producing 200 PS of power and 440 Nm of torque, mated to an 8-speed automatic transmission. Toyota has launched a new brand called Kymto, which will focus on mobility services, including sharing, subscription-based and autonomous transport. The brand will be first introduced in Europe. But the question is, every day we see some sort of technology being developed for cars and automobiles, but we hardly see them in India. What do you think is the reason for the same? Vote by clicking on the I button above and let me know your thoughts by commenting down below. And here's a poll result of Automotive News episode 56, where the question was, are Indian trucks safe? And 80% viewers have voted that they have never thought of it. 20% think that Indian trucks are not safe. The second question for the poll was, do you want automobiles to be delivered at your doorstep? And 33% viewers have voted yes, and 66% viewers have voted no, because they like the showroom feeling while buying a new car or automobile. So thank you for watching.